What is up, Facebook world? This is Kimberly and Connor Tracy over here at Big Red SEO, tuning in this beautiful Friday. Hi, Connor.
Hey, Kim.
So he had me cracking up because he has this cool little remote device on the side of his chair. And I don't know what he did, but whenever he went to click to go live, it was so loud and obnoxious. I actually thought that it fell off, but it sounds like it was the tape.
I've cheaped out. I didn't put Velcro underneath it. I put a piece of tape, or you put a piece of tape for me. Let's give credit.
What credit do? I don't know if that's the kind of credit you want to have, but like whether it's tape or Velcro, it works, right? And that's what it is. So if you guys tuned in the last 2 weeks, we have a new environment. We've brought you guys into our home. One, because I think we're a little bit more comfortable in our home, right? I can say what I want to say any way that I want to say it. The volume, though, we did just have a joke prior to going live that it would be funny if I actually did an episode whispering and then to see how that would go. I don't know if I would be able to do it because as I was saying whispering, Connor was like, "What did you say?" I yelled at him, right? So it went even louder than my normal voice.
See, so this is Kim's normal voice. Yeah. You don't really have a... She does not have an inside voice.
Yeah, some people say an inside voice. I don't know if I have one. I do sometimes. Like, sometimes I'm kind of quiet. But if I go quiet, it's usually not a good sign.
That's very true.
It's either the hurricane's about to hit, I've got some shit going on in my mind, like my thinky brain's a little on overdrive, or I'm just kind of burnt out and I, like, don't have anything left. Those are the extremes for me. So, yeah, I've always, I think even whenever I was a kid, I think I was really quiet as a kid, but it wasn't always good circumstances on why I was quiet. And then I think the older I got, just naturally had a loud voice. And like, even when you get around my mom, not to bring her into the subject, but my mom's really loud. Mm-hmm. And then my whole entire family is loud. So one time when Connor visited and met my family for the first time, he was just like, "I need Tylenol and Advil," because it was loud.
There was a bunch of people, and then there were a bunch of kids. Teenagers and just under teens and whatnot.
It was loud.
There was probably 14, 15 people. And it's just not
all talking at once, guys.
Yeah, not an environment I'm used to. So, but nonetheless.
And then you have your family, which you guys talk pretty quiet. So I would have to have them repeat what they would say, like his mom or his dad. I would have to be like, "What did you say?" Or I'd have to like lean in and pay attention because not only was it the volume, but it was also the accent as well. Mm-hmm. So it caused you to like really pay attention. So
our family was we were raised a little different in that. So coming from Ireland and all of that, one of the rules within our family, rule, I guess, was that you don't speak until it's your turn.
That doesn't work for me, guys.
Which means that you also don't get to interrupt somebody. They have to be done talking. They then go to take a breath, and then you seize your moment.
Yeah, because if you don't, somebody else is going to take it over. But I will say, being married to this guy, guys, we just celebrated our anniversary yesterday for 9 years. High five on that. Like, I don't know if that was a good high five. I feel like we've done
enough.
Better.
But I will say,
like, yes, he doesn't really interrupt, but then he does interrupt. And this is a behind the scenes thing that happens is I'll be working on something and he is like not comprehending that I'm working on something. So he just starts talking. And in most cases, you guys probably know we work side by side. We love working together. So we found ways to like learn each other and mold around. However, like sometimes he has these random bits of information that he wants to literally share with me at any moment, any time. And so he just starts blurting out, or I'll be in a conversation and he'll pick something else up. And like, whether I'm in a good mood, if I'm in a good mood, it goes great. If I'm in hurricane mode, it does not go very good.
Yeah, if you're in concentration mode, it's not that great.
I think like earlier this week, I was like, "Do you not see that I'm doing something at my desk?"
Honestly, the answer is,
and he like so calmly was like, "No, actually I did." He was like super serious. But I think that that's also the thing as a married couple that works side by side, we're so next to each other and into each other that we probably don't really pay attention to certain things. And in other areas we do, like we both kind of know when we need to step away from our desks and walk away, or when we need to take a break. But you guys have a glimpse of us into our little world of tidbits. So today, Connor wanted to bring you some information about Google My Business. They have updated a lot of different stuff, which he's excited to share today. Hopefully, you guys have a Google My Business listing. If you don't, if you've never heard of it, there are a shit ton of videos that Connor has created about this and shows the benefits of a business. It is a free listing. It's worth putting the time and the effort into. With that being said, do you want to just dive in?
Sure.
The quiet.
So as Kim said, Google My Business. If you go to google.com/business, you can list all your company information, your hours, your address, all that information that needs to be shown. And even if you work from home, you should still have a Google Business listing and at least have some of the base information, phone number, hours, contact methods. Maybe not show your map if you're working from home. You don't want to have people showing up at your house. It's also not allowed inside of Google's guidelines currently. Now, with the whole COVID-19 stuff, things are changing. And that's part of what today's thing is. You know, there's a number of items that have changed in Google My Business, not just for individuals, but then for chains and for people that have 10 or 15 or 100 locations. Extra things have changed in there. I'm not going to get into those because our general audience is usually a one or a two person or two location. So I'll stick to that that area, I guess it is. But anyway, let me bring up just a quick sheet that I have on what was going on. And hopefully y'all don't see my face as I
try to old man reach, faces, he tries to read.
Reach for my computer. And
get try that to ab workout. Get that ab workout.
It's an ab workout. Yeah, Allie will be happy. Anyway, these are some of the new attributes that are on the system. So we've had veteran-led and women-led as being attributes as part of Google My Business. And we use the women-led. Kim's the boss here. So, hey, look at that. The camera thing kicked in now.
You saw yourself full
I did.
Throttle.
So I got to wait for the social media thing to be done before I can get back into my PDF.
This is where we play the music. If we had the music, quack, quack, duck.
Isn't it, though?
It'd be funny. Yeah.
All right. Come on.
It's the learning that
comes
out.
Come on, computer. Get back in.
So you probably need a shorter social media button.
Well, it's because it changes scenes. So here you go, back into the regular scene. So veteran-led, women-led, we use the women-led one. If you're in a restaurant or a bar, some of the items that were added there for the COVID-19, you've got a dine-in, takeaway, delivery. You've also got the options for curbside pickup or a no-contact delivery. So those were things that were added because of what's going on. Whether that's going to stay long-term or not is unknown, but they are in there as options right now. But the four new items that came up this week, and these are things that you can take advantage of. One of it is online care. We've got online appointments, online estimates, and online classes. And where all this comes into play is that, you know, within our business listing, we have the option for the online appointments.
Yep.
Because that's one of the classifications within the SEO industries that we have online appointments. We also have the option to do the online classes. Now, we don't get the option for curbside pickup or dine in. So Google is a little smarter than giving credit at times. But essentially, depending on your industry, you'll have different options available to you. We're not going, you know, a pizza place is not going to have, you know, online classes generally. It would be interesting to do an online pizza class. That would be kind of cool, actually.
That would be weird.
Wouldn't it?
But you don't cook very much.
Well, I don't.
Okay, side story, since he brought it up. We tried cooking pizza once, and we did horribly bad because what we did was we put so much topping on top of the pizza. Do you remember this?
I do.
And then I don't remember. We might not have put a pan underneath the pizza. Because
no. We didn't. Might not have. Kim did not put a pan.
So I don't know if y'all do this or not, but how I was raised, and it's not even a matter of raised, but we used to do frozen pizzas, right? And then, like they say, have a pan, but a lot of times we couldn't afford a pan. So we just put the pizza directly on the rack, right? Like a frozen pizza on the rack. So in my brain, the thought process is, Well, if we make a pizza and it's fresh, we could do the exact same thing. But what I didn't take into account was that there was actually the toppings were so heavy that it went through the dough. Now, the benefit for me was I was like, oh, well, if something falls out, I don't want it to hit the burner in the bottom. So I actually put a sheet pan underneath the pizza on the next rack, which caught it. But y'all, it was a horrible mess. Like, it was like a soupy, I don't know. The top of the pizza was burnt. It was horrible. So needless to say, we called like some other big box pizza place to have it deliver after. But anyway,
there's the pizza.
So we should not do a pizza online course.
No, probably not online. So depending on your industry, you're going to get different options within the system. If you are a veteran, you know, every veteran that I know is proud to be a veteran. So fly that flag or the badges or anything else, put that on your Google business listing. You know, a lot of veterans will do work with other veterans because they're a veteran.
And that's the thing a lot with these tags, guys, like something to take in consideration. People vote with their money, right? They vote where they take their business. And if they have a certain thing that they align with, a mission, a purpose, then they're going to actually do business with those people that have those tagged. So it is worth doing it. Also, just a side note that depending on what tag you use, also make sure that you put that inside your website content on your actual website as well, because people do read it and they do care, right?
Yep. There was a flag on there that it was family-run business. That flag is now removed, and the women-led is still there.
Yep.
I'm sure it's a matter of time before we get the a black-run business or variations of that that will show up onto the listings.
Yep.
The listings themselves, these are called attributes. So if you go into Google My Biz or google.com/business, go under info, and then down near the services section, it has these attributes. And these are flags that'll show on the actual listing, the knowledge panel. When you do a search for a business, and on the right-hand side, it's got a little panel of information. Those flags are going to step out. Now, there are other assets I can't remember what it's called, items
attributes,
maybe, that will show that, you know, whether you have parking available, Wi-Fi, free coffee, you know, when you're dealing with the hotels, whether it has a pool or a spa. So those things are also items that should be filled out. They're not the same as these attributes. These ones are ones that show up differently, and they stand out a lot better. So use that. I mean, we talked about telehealth stuff before.
Yep.
There's options in there for that. The online care. A pizza place or us as an SEO company, we're not going to get the online care flag available to us.
Right.
Now, if you believe that you deserve a flag and that's not in there, you can open up a help tech ticket with Google. Click the question mark, top right hand side, and open up a ticket with them. And let them know, hey, this is our business and this is what we do. We should have this particular flag.
Right.
So out of any of the items that I provided, so here they are on the screen again, we've got veteran-led, women-led, dine-in, takeaway, delivery, curbside pickup, no contact delivery, online care, online appointments, online estimates, and online classes. Mm-hmm. If you have any of those items that your business does and you don't have that flag, go ahead and request from Google. The online estimates is a great one.
Yeah.
You know, whether you're a pest control company or a carpet clean company, if you have online estimates available, you should flag that. Now, it does mean that it has to be a true estimate, not just a contact form that somebody then will contact you with an estimate.
Mm-hmm.
It has to be, you give in the specs of what it is you want, and it gives you a number, and it's all online, and you don't need to talk to somebody. That qualifies as an online estimate.
Right.
So that's what's going on. Now, that's the latest stuff. There's other crap happening with Google, of course, but, you know, this is the main one for today.
Now, a side note I want to talk about really quickly. It's a little bit different because it's not a Google My Business update on the listings. However, Connor, you've heard Rebelings and you've actually seen within your mentorship as well as forums, if somebody has tagged themselves as closed for COVID-19 or closed as a business, they're having troubles with getting their stuff updated. So can you provide any feedback about what you've heard, what's going on? I know you might not have a solution, but if somebody is at home and they're having issues, what do they need to look at?
Yeah, I don't have a solution that I can just provide on that. But essentially, what was happening was that if you, in the very beginning of the COVID-19 stuff, you had the option to close your business for COVID-19. Well, now that, I don't want to say that's passed, but now that all the businesses are back open again, everybody wants their business to be marked as open. But a lot of people are having trouble with that. Google is not releasing the flag. Some of it has to do with the skeleton crew that Google is operating.
Right. You know,
they don't have a ton of people working at Google. A lot of them are still on paid leave. So as a result, that process is taking longer. But if you do run into the situation where your business is open and that flag is not removing, contact me. Send us an email through our website, BigRedSEO.com, and I can run that up the chain through the different contacts that we have.
And I was going to say, do us a favor, don't wait until the last minute, right? So if you're running into that situation, let him know. He cannot say he can influence Google by any means. It's not legally able to do that.
Nope.
However, he does hear rumblings within certain places, so we are helping some people out.
Yeah, we have liaisons and contacts within our industry that we're able to run things up the chain. And some of them are other SEO companies that I work with.
And I would just say that if somebody does say that they're with Google and or they have a straight line to Google, they're filled with shit. So don't listen to that, y'all. Don't listen to that. Okay, so Carolina tuned in. Hey, Carolina, hope you and the family are great.
Hello.
She said, hi, how are you guys doing? We're doing honestly fabulous. Mm-hmm. I mean, every single day, like I was just literally talking to a jeweler, what was it, yesterday, the day before. Interesting for their industry, just a side note story, their insurance companies came through when there was a bunch of the rioting activity and they said, vault everything, close everything. So she actually didn't know how long her business was going to be closed. It already was closed because of COVID and so forth. Now she's actually transformed her entire business model to do appointments only. So she's actually, what do you call that? Like, I would think white glove service. So somebody wants a necklace or
exclusive
jewelry. It's actually an exclusive. You have the entire studio to yourself. I actually experienced that myself and it was really, really cool.
And guys, that is the only way to shop.
I will be honest, like walking in and not feeling pressure, or you have to move somewhere and she was just right there when I had questions. It was like a level step up, right? And you and I have spent some time in some jewelry stores, so we kind of know. Mm-hmm. But really cool how she spun that around. But for her, she wasn't sure. So she had to vault everything, right? But for us, like with this, the whole entire situation, at the very beginning, we were just like, we're going to get up every single day and do the best that we can. Mm-hmm. And if for whatever reason we fell short from the best, we would just acknowledge it and then the next day commit to do it again. And literally, guys, that's what we've done. I don't want to say that nothing has changed for us because it actually has. We work from home now and we absolutely love it. We still do have our store location or our office location. Brad handles all of that. He's an awesome landlord and everybody over there. But we love working from home. We love having Bailey's with us. She's actually underneath our feet right now, right? We're busier now than we have ever been before in business. Mm-hmm. I got into the gym probably, 3 weeks ago because I was like, okay, it's done. I've got Marsha over at Losing It that's helping me slim down. They've been a client for many, many years, but I walked in and I said, okay, I'm ready. Let's go in full fledged. And then now you have started your own program based on that. So we've actually found a way to be able to turn into the best lives and look at where do we need to step it up? And at the same time, where do we just need to take a step back and back away? So overall, business has been really, really good. And the people that we're onboarding, the new clients that are coming in, as well as our existing clients, they're really aligned with what we do and how we do things, which is really, really, really cool. So it's less tire kickers, less let's go for the lowest bang for the buck. Like, let's just get it done quick and easy and cheap and whatever.
Well, even we had a contact the other day.
Yeah.
So we did an event back in 2018. We did an intro to SEO,
yep.
A whole guidance of that. We had a I don't know, a dozen and a half people.
It was like 16 people in the class, yeah.
That showed up, and you know, we actually did an online, not an online, but an in-person training for,
it was like a 3.5-4 hour training. And this was like years back. So I would actually break that up into 6 sessions now. I mean, we hammered them with information, but it was good. And yes, so like we even say, like whenever we get into contact with somebody, we don't know when they're going to come circling back around. Mm-hmm. But this one just happened. Her cousin attended an event, and 2 years later, now we have a call with them next week to see how we can help.
It's kind of crazy. Really cool. You know, a lot of SEO companies, a lot of businesses in general are hungry for the sale, you know, and you really go aggressive on the sale. Thankfully, the way our business is structured, we're a no pressure kind of setup.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting. I've been in sales that went black. I don't know if it was supposed to go black.
I don't know.
Hopefully you guys can still hear us. I'm going to keep talking like you can. So I've been in sales the majority of my career, and/or I was in doing waitress, right? So it was like one or two types of things. And I've done door-to-door sales. I've done cold calling. I've done picking up the phone and calling somebody blind, right? I've grabbed the yellow pages and I've done that, not necessarily in our business, right? But whenever I built this business model, I actually did not want to do that. Like, it's not what comes natural for me. And what I mean by that, guys, is I've been trained to do it, and I can do it, and I can get really good results. It just doesn't feel organic for me, if that makes sense. And so with that, whenever we actually do business and we actually vet out the people that come to us, as well as they vet us out, right? Like for us, it's an energy exchange. So we want to make sure that we're all aligned. And sometimes we can't help people. Like sometimes it's out of our bucket. Maybe they don't want to go to WordPress. Maybe there's something else. And so the stars don't align and we actually don't work with them, but we always lead them to the value, or at least to the next step for them to get across the bridge of where do they need to go, right? So rarely do we ever leave somebody like super blind and not knowing what the next step is. And based on that process itself, we've actually had people come back around and say, no, we don't want to do WordPress. We don't want to go that. And then 30 days later, they'll contact us and say, okay, let's go. Right. But the sales, like I've done the hard sales. I kind of tested it last year. It works. It does work. I don't want to say it doesn't work, but for me, it feels pretty yicky. I would rather like say, here's the value. This is how we can help you. Let us know. And then I take a step back and I help lead him quite a lot in that. Take a step back. And if the stars align, cool. And if they don't, that's cool as well. Like we don't really get our feelings hurt if somebody tells us no. We just want to make sure that they're headed down the right path. Mm-hmm. And if they've chosen somebody else, and this is what I help people with that I coach. If they've chosen somebody else in our industry, we actually thank them for doing that versus DIY. Like we do help train people in DIY, right? But if they've chose a competitor of ours, that means that they're still in the running, as in they're interested in investing in our industry, right? Mm-hmm. Versus DIY or screw it, I'll just go off and do only TV and radio, right? So it's a little bit of a different mindset, but I wanted to share that with you guys because it has made a difference in our business and we've been growing strong like in the entire time that we've been in business. So a little inside scoop there for you. Carolina said that they just got a new puppy. Yay. Congratulations on expanding your family there. She said, Connor, she loves your shirt. So Carolina, that is actually located, I think they might still have them, at Wolf and Whiskers out west. So I think it's 147th in Maple, maybe, or 147th in Blondo. It's next to Kelly Miller. So if you know the Kelly Miller, which I know you've been there a lot, we've been there together. So it's right next to that little nook. A husband and wife team own it. And they have all sorts of stuff. Your puppy would probably have a blast in that store. That's where we get all of our goods for Little Miss Bailey's down there, including her food. But yeah, so it looks like we didn't have an image for a while, but we did have speakers. So everybody got access to the stuff. So
good.
So for those that are just tuning in live, thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to go back and watch the replay either here on Facebook, or Connor's going to download this on YouTube. If you go to our YouTube channel, you can subscribe. And every time he uploads a video, you can actually get a notification to watch it. So be sure to tune in there. And if you have any questions regarding these new features and functions in the Google My Business, reach out, right? Like we're here. We'll help you with whatever capacity that we can, with whatever scope that looks like. But this information mentioned, offering the new features is kind of a cool thing.
Yeah, and there will be more to come on that. But this is what's been disclosed so far. So
yeah, it's interesting. I feel like there's going to be a lot more changes coming through just because a lot more businesses are either working from home or they're doing virtual business or they're doing online appointments. So it's very interesting to see how the search engines are going to change and adapt with those business models because really nobody knows what the future holds at this point.
Right.
But it's kind of cool watching them break off these little areas. And believe it or not, guys, I've said this before, and I know you have too. If you're not filling this stuff out, you're missing out because it's a free listing. And if nobody in your industry is filling it out and you do, you get the boost up in the search engines. Yep. The last thing I would say before we wrap up here is online reviews. Google reviews are still highly important. I would say that they're more important now than ever. If you can get the review to be written as similar to a story situation, that's the best. So instead of somebody saying, "These are excellent window cleaners," explain the process of the window cleaning. And you can kind of help people write stories on the reviews. Try to make sure it's their words, though. And how I say that with helping people is create questions and ask them to answer the questions. Like, give them a frame template to start with, and then you would be surprised at what good reviews you can get. Cool? Awesome.
Okay.
Thanks, guys. Tune in next Friday. Until then, we will see you. Bye-bye.
All right, guys. Have a great day now. Thank you.